All right, let's do a quick little overview of this. This is something I've been started to unpack some things for me that packed up years ago, and slowly making progress on the workbench here. I've got the drywall up behind the workbench now, well, mostly anyhow. And I got the first shelf mounted there the other day. So, and you can see my expert Dremel drywall cutting bit skills here. Yeah. Anyhow, thing runs away from me, but anyhow, whatever. Back to the subject at hand. This is a Monroe 920, and this was something that came to me in a lot of vintage electronics from years ago. And just looking at it, I have to assume it's from maybe the early 70s. It's an adding machine, no printer, and it's in fair shape. All of this would have to be stripped and repainted, really, because you can see the little pot marking on the metal. This down here appears. Oh no, it's metal. This up here definitely is plastic. You see where the paint's chipped away. It's white underneath. But it's a Monroe 920. Just like to tape the power cord there. I'm sure it's all right. Got a screw missing here. Got a screw there. The original power cord. Now, did it have a grounding plug, or is it just missing here? I think it broke off. Anything on the bottom? Yes, Monroe International Division. Litton Business Systems Model 920, made in Japan. Now, what I remember of these, reading up when I first got it years ago, and I never have done anything with it. I plugged it in and it blinked, but I think this button is stuck. So I think unsticking this button may restore some usability to this. It's obviously very dirty, and now that button's stuck down. The main reason I've held on to this thing all these years is that it uses Nixie tubes for a display, and that's unusual today. They moved on from Nixie tubes pretty early on with electronic calculators and adding machines. But I am going to try to pop the cover off of this. We'll see if we can get these buttons freed up, and then we'll plug her in and see what happens. Either she'll work, she won't work, or we'll get some fireworks. Who knows? Let's see. And having a look inside, we can see that the looks like the buttons use a type of reed switch. That's the bottom of the keyboard. And of course, the zero was just hanging up because they're dirty. I don't know how long this thing has sat. And what do we have up here? Let's see. Matsushita capacitors, the electrolytics up here. We have a fuse, power supply, power transformer. Looks like some Texas Instruments. And these are dated 1969. So, this is pretty dirty. Yeah, 69. And there's Canon on the board, so this was made by Canon. Canon may be on this board somewhere, not sure. But, okay, so it's a Canon built calculator. I mean, Canon built for Monroe. Which I remember there was something about Monroe bought, had some kind of agreement with Canon, and we can see the connections for the Nixie tubes. It's all hand wired. Pretty neat. Well, I since the keys should all be back in a resting position. Let's see. Let me flip the switch and see if anything happens. And that would be nothing's gonna happen if you don't plug it in. Ought to have been 5425. So let's do that. Try that switch again. Well, you see the dots jumped and all we have is a period back here. I think that's clear. You know what? This light. Yeah, see, the display is dead at the moment. Unplug the light. If I press clear, either of the clear switches, they do that. Pressing the number switches doesn't do much. You can see there are some periods faintly lit in here. Constant switch. Yeah, so not much is, except for clear, is making it do anything. Now, sure, I could measure these voltages and see if I at least have that coming out of the transformer. But see if I have continuity on these fuses which are soldered in place. I know nothing about repairing adding machines. At least these look like hardy silicone transistors. Some have red dots on the top, some have Ys. Interesting. Well, if anybody has any guidance about where I can go read up on, or if there's a schematic available for this, but I guess point me in the right direction in the links. I'd like to play around with it. Besides checking the basics. You know, I mean, like, I'm looking at these caps here. I don't know what these caps run. No clue. There's a Zener diode there. Got some more diodes over here, which I'm sure this is all part of the power supply. And I'm sure there's more stuff underneath here. Which, yeah, pretty interesting. And that's what she's doing. Just giving us dots. Unfortunately, I'm very ill-prepared for doing anything like this right now. In fact, this meter here I received for Christmas, I believe 3 years ago. And this is the first time I'm taking it out of the box. Well, first time I'm actually going to use it. I don't know where my other meters are. Okay, so that works. DC and AC switch. Of course, I am not going to be able to hold this camera and do this. So let's see. Turn her on. We got 60 volts here, 60 volts here, 60, 60. I guess that goes to the switch. This is all AC on this bus. The 190 is reading 213. The 7.5 is reading 8.3, 8.4. And then 60, 60, 60, 60. Oh, there's more bus over here. Let's see. This is supposed to be negative 5. Plus, maybe this is the DC side. Yeah, I think so. Well, the 220 DC is reading 274. The negative 5 is negative 5.6. E, whatever E is 9.3. Plus 5 is 5.28. And then C, 5.2. B, 9.1. So yeah. Take the power off of it. Let's see. Continuity. So that fuse is good. That fuse is good. Is this a cap checker here? I think so. This is in circuit. The 5 microfarads reading 11. This is a 33 here. This isn't even reading. That one's not reading anything either. Well, I think this thing needs a good blowing out here, some cleaning of the switches, and I need to get a hold of some type of schematic to help me at least go through the power supply. Although this looks pretty simple, I just wish I had something to look at. But if anybody knows where I might find anything like that,